Alrighty, great to be here. This is Politics in Prime Time. Let's get on with it and some questions and answers that have caught my eye this week. Question: why is banning mining on conservation land now looming as such a big flashpoint for the coalition government? Maybe it's because of this guy.
The mining sector is already a part of the political economy of that part of the country. The statutory decisions lie with other ministers, but the quality of my advocacy will continue because, unlike that member, sir, I'm a lion in the regions, I'm a lion in the House, but I am not a wimp when I go back to Epsom.
Yes, because while Labor and the Greens want to ban, the self-proclaimed champion of the regions, Shane Jones, wants mining in places like the West Coast to continue. And Jones, as we see, isn't going to be easily tamed. Question: should New Zealand stick to the ambitious goal of being smoke-free by 2025? Well, the answer most would say is surely yes, but, and it's a big but, no pun intended, if we did get there, the government would need to find another $2 billion that it currently gets in taxes. I wonder how we could get that. Legalised cannabis, perhaps? Remember, a referendum is on the way. You may get to choose. Question: on that note, how cunning was it for the National Party leader Simon Bridges to suddenly promote medicinal cannabis laws that are more liberal than Labor's? Well, the answer to that question is very. I mean, this was super cynical stuff from the Nats. They did nothing on this for 9 years. But it is also smart. It does allow Simon Bridges to stamp his mark on the party, and it puts pressure on the government and Winston Peters to put party politics aside and work together.
I mean, I think we know what about Mr. Peters is that he's famously mercurial, and nothing would surprise me with Mr. Peters. I'd like to think he will give this a serious consideration.